So welcome back to a new episode of Gaming Pickups. I checked out my channel to see when the last time I made such a video. And in my memory, it was kind of like 2 months ago or 3 months ago. It's been eight months ago since I made my last pickup video. Holy damn, time flies so fast. And this is basically what I got in 8 months. There's probably a little bit more, but not that much more. It's still a lot of games, definitely, but I am very happy that it slowed down the way it did. I mean, it's not that much compared to what I usually got. Holy damn. So let's start off with something really cool. A friend of mine, he all of a sudden said, I have a GameCube and I don't do anything with it. Do you want it? And I'm like, of course. I mean, I never played. I did play on the GameCube. I never got a GameCube. So I said, yes. Yeah. So he gave me the GameCube, and it is in holy damn, like, perfect state. Even the air vents are not even dusty. They're still shiny, like it's never been used before. Like, it is weird how good the condition is for this GameCube. So really cool that I got this. I got it with two controllers and exactly the same. It looks like the controllers are maybe used like a month or so. It's no dust, no dirt, completely clean, very cool. Now he only had the GameCube, so I kind of had to get some games for it. But the problem with the GameCube is when you have such a big PS2 library, is that the GameCube did have some really good exclusives, but not so many. And they didn't really sell the way it did, you know, on PS2, the PS2 exclusives, if you know what I mean. So games like Mario Sunshine are awesome games, but they're very, very hard to find. And they are pretty expensive. And especially from the genre that I love, you know, the Japanese games, many of these games are multi-platform. I already have those on PS2. And the exclusives one are really expensive. But I still got two games. I think it was a bundle of 12 bucks. Is Mystic Heroes. And this is a multi-platform game, but I don't have it on PS2. And Phantasy Star 3, is it online? No, yeah, Phantasy Star Online 3. So these two games I got for 12 bucks, and it's a card game. I didn't even know that, so I still have to check this game out. So yes, really cool that I got the GameCube. You know, next generation is probably the last generation that I'll be in. Next one in 10 years time, who knows where I'll be. But I do think that gaming will be streaming only or digital only. So it's probably time to get some other systems. Now on the PS2, a couple of my friends were out on a different city. And we checked a local game store. And they had a couple of games that I was interested in. And last week we went to a local game store called Gamania here. And they had a really cool game that I saw when I went in the store, and I right away got it. So first up is SOCOM Combined Assault. It's the pack with the headset, and the headset is still here. I probably will never use it because probably someone else already used it, or maybe not. I did play the game. I do want to beat the game. I was a huge fan of SOCOM. I loved SOCOM, but you can definitely see it's an older game. It looks kind of, it doesn't look terrible, but, you know, it looks old. I got Death by Degree. It's a game I also still want to play. It's kind of a bad game from what I've heard, but I never got it. True Crime, New York City. And this is the game that I saw in a bargain bin for 10 bucks, and I didn't have it, and I have to get it. Was Castlevania. Here's just called Castlevania, but it's Lament of Innocence. And 2 days ago, I actually beat the game. It took me 13 hours, a couple of tries at the end, But I beat this game. I beat a PS2 game on original PS2 hardware. That was really cool. And this is just a game from SOCOM Combined Assault. There are not many PS3 games that I still want or need or should get, but these were on sale for like $2 each. And I'm like, I kind of remember playing these games, at least two of these games. But in 2011, I had sort of like a gaming depression. I sold a lot of games, and some of these were these games, but I kind of wanted to get them back because it's still sort of, you know, history of what I played. And it's a bad game, but Eat Lead is a game I played, and I kind of enjoyed it back in the, when I played it. Dark Sector is a game that I've heard some pretty good things about, but I never played. And X-Blade, I actually got the collector's editions for X-Blade, but I probably sold it because I don't have the game anymore. You don't see this game that often. It's kind of weird. It's not an expensive game, you just don't see it that often. And I had some good memories of it, so I had to get this one too. They're in okay condition, not perfect, not bad. Now, the Nintendo Switch. Nintendo Switch is a very cool system. There are a shit ton of physical games out there. Some of them have like 500, 600, 700 physical games already. Who knows? Maybe at the end of it all, it may outperform even the PS4 in the amount of games and the amount of systems sold and whatever. Most of these games, though, are from limited run games. And one of them is Celeste, the game I still need to play. Transistor, Bloodstained Curse of the Moon. I did play this game and beat it in one night. Very cool retro style Castlevania-ish game. And Bloodstained is freaking awesome. The Messenger is also a game that I played. Kind of sucked that all the patches and DLC were not on disc. And this game is hard. I am stuck at one boss. It just makes me freaking go insane. And I haven't really played it after that. I played it for a couple of days until I was stuck at that boss. The Legend of Zelda's Link Awakening. Very fun game. I really tried to get into it. I also played A Link to the Past quite a bit. Pretty far actually. I'm 12 hours into the game. I don't know what it is. Whoops. Somehow, this type of game gets boring. I'm sorry, I just don't know why. I just couldn't really get into it as I was into Breath of the Wild. So, Momotaro Reverie Under the Moonlight is also a Metroidvania-ish game. I did play it, but it didn't really hook me as like another Metroidvania game like Time Spinner. Holy shit, Time Spinner is also a game I actually got. So, where is it? Where are you, Time Spinner? Oh, here it is. Here, also a Metroidvania game that I got in the 8 months. And this one was awesome, even though it's a PS4 game. A game I still need to play is Momuro Chronicle H. H, is it like hentai? Kind of weird. I remember this game on the Vita. It never got a physical release, so I had to get it for the Switch when Limited Run posted on their site. Battle Princess Madeline, the Royal Edition, kind of like a Ghosts and Goblins or Ghosts and Ghouls-ish game. And I did play it, and it's actually really fun. It's a really fun game. A game that I got two days ago in the mail, New Super Lucky Tales. I've heard so many good things about this game. And you know what? I started it yesterday, and I beat it today. This game is awesome. It reminds me a lot of Super Mario Odyssey, and Super Mario Odyssey is an amazing game. It is not as good as, but it's kind of in the same vibe, in my personal opinion. It's a really small game. It's not hard at all. I mean, the last boss was pretty hard, but in general, this game is not hard, but it's a lot of fun to play. And for me personally, these 3D platformers, some of them try to be really hard and just annoys me. I just want to have fun, and that is this game. If you want to have a 3D platformer like Super Mario Odyssey, go get this game. It's really cool. Oops. This is the game I actually played like an hour ago, and it's Danmaku Unlimited 3, a really cool Japanese shmup. Freakishly hard though. Even on easy, I just can't seem to beat the game. All these shmups are always trying to get the highest score possible. I've never been that kind of a gamer. I just play the shmup. It's kind of weird because I spent like 30, 35 bucks on it, and I probably played it for an hour, and I already had this feeling of like, okay, it's good enough. I played it. It's kind of weird. But still, it's always with the shmups. Like, I love playing shmups, but just for a very short while, and then I'm just like, okay, I've seen it. Now, on to the PS4, my main system, of course, as you know it now. As I mentioned, Time Spinner, freaking awesome game. Atelier, Luigi, and Suella finally got into Atelier again. Atelier, whatever. Really tried to like it, and I did like it, but it got really repetitive in the way they build up the story. And I think after like 25, 30 hours, again, I stopped playing. It's every Atelier game in the new style that is not Atelier Iris 2 or 1 or 3, it gets boring after a while. So I still want to play the others though. Knights of Azure 2, really cool game, I beat it. Dragon Quest Builders 2 greatly improves upon the first one, and I actually need to get more into this game. I finally got Persona 5, Dancing in the Starlight. The other one is Persona 3, Dancing in the Moonlight. This is by far the better version, not because it's a better game, just the music is a lot better in this game, and I beat it. Resident Evil 2, the remake, holy shit, this game is awesome. I can't freaking wait. Why? I am going to wait for the Resident Evil 3 remake. I beat this game. Really, really cool game. Devil May Cry 5. Devil May Cry finally got back. I think I got this game like in June or July last year, something like that, for 25 bucks. Played it. I think I beat it in like 1 or 2 days. Awesome experience. Freaking amazing game. Kingdom Hearts 3, I did start playing it, but somehow I stopped. I kind of need to go back to it one day. Super Beat Sonic EX, sort of an upgraded version of the original game. Have not played it yet though. Bladestorm Nightmare, Blue Reflection, Tomb Raider, the Definitive Edition. Now, this version has all the DLC and patches on disc, and that's why I got this one. I'm definitely looking forward to playing this game. Sword Art Online, what is this? Axel World Fea Sword Art Online. Was really anticipating playing this game, and I played Lost Song. It's kind of exactly the same, and that kind of got boring, to be honest. Spider-Man and Days Gone. Amazing games, absolutely incredible games. Even got a platinum on Days Gone. It's just mindless. You have to get these ones, of course. Yooka-Laylee and the Impossible Lair. Haven't played it yet. Got this for my birthday from a friend. Mercenary Kings, really Reloaded. If you like, what's that game called? Holy damn, I forgot the name. I had it in the tip of my tongue. Metal Slug. If you like Metal Slug, you're gonna like this game. It's sort of like a mix between Metal Slug and Borderlands. Really cool. River City Girls. Played this quite a bit with a friend of mine, and a very fun game. It's just that it's really long, in my personal opinion, and I haven't played it. I haven't beat it just yet. Mercenary Wings. Still need to play it. Soul Calibur 6. Is it 6? Yeah, Soul Calibur. Is it 6? Yes. It's Soul Calibur 6. Got this on a pretty good deal. Still need to play it. Holy shit. Gunfold Chronicles Luminous Adventure X. It looks so freaking cool. Why haven't I played it yet? Looks so freaking cool. From Limited Run. Vazara Collection from Strictly Limited. Is it from Strictly Limited? Probably, yeah. It's from Strictly Limited. Finally got the version. still need to play it. Super Combo is like a compilation of two fighting games that, if I recall correctly, never came to the West. Me and my buddies kind of played it a bit, and it's a fun game. It's definitely fun. It looks really cool. Azur Lane Crosswave, also a limited run Idea Factory game. And didn't knew the game would also come out in stores, or else I would have waited instead of paying $60 for freaking limited run. They should say that on their freaking site when a game is also available just in stores. But it doesn't matter, because I clocked in about 50 hours into the game. I beat it. Almost got platinum on it. I just didn't want to grind for all the freaking girls. But this game is awesome. It's really repetitive. It's really simple. But somehow it's so freaking cool. And I love the art style. Really cool. I got this game from a colleague of mine, Men of Medan. Beat it in one sitting. Really, really cool story-driven game. If you like Until Dawn, Detroit, Heavy Rain, go get this one. I think the second one is coming out this year. God Wars Future Press, a really cool, awesome looking, simple tactical RPG. I played quite a bit actually. I think I did 20 hours in the game, 25 hours, but haven't beat it, probably won't. And this is kind of the game that I'm looking for, like, should I play it today or not? That is Blasphemous. I've heard so many good things about this game. It looks so fucking cool. I probably will play it today. I already opened it up and it's already installed on PS4. It sadly does have a patch, but it probably won't be that big. So yeah, these are all the games that I got in about 8 months' time. It's not that much, as you can see. And this year could potentially be a lot bigger in the ways of buying games, since, you know, the next generation is going to be upon us. And I definitely suspect, like, Black Friday and spring deals to be pretty freaking good. You know, games that were $20 in sale last year, maybe $15 or $10 in sale this year. So, but we will see. Maybe I won't even get that much. I am beating and playing quite a lot of games this month. I already beaten 3 or 4 games. I'm pretty proud of myself, to be completely honest. I've beaten quite a lot of games in these past years. So, we shall see. Leave it in the comments below. Which games did you buy? Like, share, comment, and subscribe. And like always, you're gonna see me next time. And I'm singing here